Here comes Jey Uso,
a man who has grown immeasurably under the Bloodline.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, representing the Usos from San Francisco, California, weighing in at 242 pounds. Main event, Jey Uso!
Main event, Jey Uso.
The right-hand man to the head of the table has held many tag team championships, but won the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. Main evented, the sky is the limit for Jey Uso.
Perhaps the most entertaining Hall of Famer in history.
And his opponent from the Isle of Samoa, weighing in at 425 pounds, Rikishi!
He's held the Intercontinental Championship, multiple tag team titles.
And Kishi may be the best dancer in WWE history, besides you, Cole.
Thanks, Corey. I won a number of dance contests.
Hey, do you guys know I used to watch Rikishi tapes to get ready for my eighth
grade? Anyhow, Corey, what do you think about Rikishi and his career?
I think Rikishi is one of the most fun-loving yet dominant WWE superstars we have ever seen. Deceptively agile, hard-hitting, and no one has more fun than the big man.
What about me?
Saxton, get off the desk. This is not permission for you to twerk.
Ah, raising the roof, Corey. Watch me.
Rikishi may be best known for busting a move and delivering stink faces, but when he needs to, the Samoan superstar is capable of some pretty brutal attacks.
Yeah, if you look past all of Rikishi's goofy antics, you'll see a warrior who is as tough as they come. A man who fought his way through the Attitude Era and beyond, finding plenty of success along the way.
Will we get the party animal or the ferocious competitor? Maybe even a little of both.
And staring him down is Jey Uso, a superstar who is a true natural in the ring, hailing from a legendary bloodline of sports entertainment legends, including Hall of Fame father. Jey Uso was born to do this and has applied a cold-hearted approach to his own legacy.
Jey knows when he gets in the ring, he represents one of the most dominant families in our history. I think his refusal to let them down is admirable, whatever the cost may be. Jey's gonna make his family proud.
Reversal, can they go on the attack? Jey back. Heads out of the ring, but needs to be mindful of the referee's count here. What kind of offense do we need to see from Rikishi tonight if he wants to come out on top of the win?
We need to see his versatile offense. Rikishi's a veteran with a deep play.
He can pin his opponent right here. He kicks out instantly.
He's nowhere near ready to stop fighting yet.
He's turning the tables. Jey Uso can withstand much more of this.
Rikishi is digging deep into his playbook, utilizing some versatile offense to great effect.
Oh my goodness.
Jey puts a stop to that.
And that might be the start of the momentum swing that Jey needed.
But Jey still has more to do to get this fight fully in his favor. Rikishi's grabbing a hold.
Ooh, DDT.
And there was some force on that move.
That is just insulting.
Boom. And an uppercut.
What a counter.
Boot to the gut will stop anyone in their tracks.
That hurt.
Rikishi slowing down now.
He finds a counter for Jey. Rikishi is picking the competition apart.
You're not going to see Rikishi show any remorse.
Uh-oh, he could be looking for a submission here. Camel clutch applied. Oh, look at that arc. And he chooses to let go of the hold.
But just the amount of time he was in that submission could be very significant.
And he sends him into the corner. Gets him with the counter.
But Jay still has more to do to get this fight fully in his favor.
Insults have been hurled both in person and online, but now they can finally settle things in the ring.
It's been a long time coming, and the WWE Universe has been looking forward to it almost as eagerly as these superstars.
Their rivalry certainly has turned this into a must-see match.
Ah, the reversal by Rikishi. Countered it just in time.
He didn't come here to watch him boast and taunt.
Boom. Now uppercut. Nasty.
Neckbreaker.
Rikishi able to dodge that.
Uh-oh. He finds a counter for Jay.
Oh, my goodness. Ah, what a smash.
That is just insulting.
Jumping clothesline! What agility!
He saw it coming, taking advantage.
Ooh, well measured.
Put it in the corner.
Headbutt delivered by Rikishi. Ready to inflict more damage. Here it comes!
Rock shaker from Rikishi.
Jay is down and out.
There's two!
He manages to kick out. What strength!
An emphatic kick out from Jey Uso. How in the world did he get the shoulder up?
And the heaviest hit on the arm shoulder is not enough.
And you gotta think, he's just one final blow away from not kicking out next time.
Oh, clothesline!
Ooh, just ate that kick to the face.
Ah, the reversal by Rikishi.
Power slam, good night.
Oh, and that buys some time. And an impactful display of offense we just witnessed there.
And now a series of stomps and kicks.
Oh, my God.
DDT!
Spiked him. Look at Jey Uso going top rope.
Insult to injury. It simply doesn't get any worse than this, guys.
Stink face!
And this is what I love about Rikishi.
He may get the three count right here.
This is it.
And he is celebrating.
Look out behind you. Oh, look out! Send him packing.
And now he can celebrate.
The Judgment Day is here.
And the WWE Universe will feel their wrath.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, representing the Judgment Day. From Bray, County Wicklow, Ireland, weighing in at 190 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, Finn Balor.
Well, the frightening thing about the Judgment Day is that their main goal seems to be spreading fear throughout WWE.
Make no mistake, the Judgment Day are all about wins and championships, but the psychological warfare they wage will keep this group atop WWE.
It goes without saying, toppling the game can define this man's career, but it will also take a monumental effort to defeat Triple H.
The game has arrived. The Cerebral Assassin ready to engage in warfare.
This is gonna be good.
And his opponent, representing D-Generation X from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 255 pounds, Triple H!
It's all about the game and how you play it, and nobody plays it better than Triple H. Oh, the Cerebral Assassin, an unbelievable talent in the ring, the sadistic son-in-law of the chairman of WWE,
to Evolution. We have seen Triple H amass power in WWE, cultivating strength in numbers.
But there's no more room under the learning tree of the Cerebral Assassin. Now he's all about earning the gold and glory for himself.
Indeed, the game has never been more dangerous. Whose time here in WWE has somewhat been defined by his uncanny ability to deliver when it comes to high-pressure situations.
Cole, you sound surprised that a top star like Balor carries himself as such. If anything, you should be more concerned with his opposition, because if you come at the Prince, you best not miss.
Balor certainly makes for one heck of a challenge in the ring.
And with Triple H, you're looking at a living legend who has accomplished everything there is to accomplish here in WWE, and yet still seems to have something more to prove.
COO of the entire company, molds the future of this business with NXT, but the one thing he strives to prove is that when it comes to the in-ring game, he's still got it. That's all that's on Triple H's mind here tonight.
All night long!
Corey, I gotta ask, what do you think is the best strategy to even stand a chance against Triple H in this matchup?
Look, Triple H is many things, but one thing I don't think you could ever confuse him for is a speed demon. Triple H absolutely loves a slow, methodical pace, so the obvious counter to that is to do quite the opposite, speed things up.
Shot after shot, they're slamming their face down. Ooh!
But he stays ahead of Triple H. Drops the hammer
right on the lower back.
And
and Triple H had that scouted.
Ooh. Hooked up and
DDT.
Shoulders down. This could be it.
Triple H kicks out of the pin early.
Not even close to down and out at this point.
All right, that's it.
He gets sent down to the floor. He heads outside. Countouts legal in this match.
Triple H questioning whether he can still hang.
Yeah, Balor putting his big match expertise to work there, making it look just effortless.
Ah, gets cracked by the overhand. Triple H plants him with a spine buster. And that right there should definitively answer any questions of whether or not Triple H has still got it.
Executed with absolute authority.
Side kick finds the mark.
That kick will stop you in your tracks.
Triple H.
Triple H looking to end this match.
Wow, Triple H got it.
Two. No, he beats the count.
Balor's arm shot up like a rocket after that two count.
And guys, Triple H is in a rare moment of confusion. The game thought he had enough to end this, but his instincts were wrong.
He was elusive there.
Counter, and now there's an opening.
Nothing he can do.
DDT.
Oh, he retaliates.
And countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside.
It is clear Finn Balor is feeling the pure brutality of this fight.
And he has just taken an extraordinary amount of abuse.
And Triple H well scouted. Veteran instincts from Triple H.
Evades their offense.
Showing some extra scouting, knowing how to answer a counter with a counter of your own.
Delivers a blow to the gut.
Strong right forearm.
Start counting, Saxton.
One, two, three.
We could be here all day.
Power.
I think you're right.
Rotating vertical suplex. Nicely done.
Of defeat.
And you can see the gears in Triple H's head turning as he's racking his brain for a new scheme to get the win here.
Both arms hooked.
The big gun fired yet again.
Shoulders down.
Somehow he kicked out.
A truly extraordinary kick out by Finn Balor.
Triple H so used to ending matches like that, but tonight is going to be just a little bit tougher for the game. We knew we were in for something special between these competitors, but they are taking things over their own limits.
Brilliant countering by Booker.
It's cinched in. This could be over. This is...
We're going to free the arm and does just that.
Snap suplex
so quick.
Was punched in the ribs. They're lining up their opponent. What do they have in mind? Well placed, he dropped in the skull. Ooh. Oh, what a punch.
That's how you stop your opponent.
And back in the ring we go.
Shows the
wherewithal.
Oh.
That was nasty. For the win, he breaks
gonna take.
Off the turnbuckles.
What's he gonna do?
He must have seen that coming. Ooh, taking out the knee. Sight set on the top rope.
Now we're looking for Lita. Cross by Balor.
Balor could take this one.
Makes the cover. Oh, how?
Call it veteran instinct. Call it being just that damn good. Triple H is still in this one with that kick out.
And Balor in complete and utter shock right now. That was supposed to be it. You can sense it. This crowd is on pins and needles.
The WWE Universe is ready to erupt. Are we close to the beginning of it yet?
This is where Finn Balor's at home.
Here is your winner, Triple H!
A statement victory by this guy tonight.
Is there a club for losers Finn Balor can join after that performance?
Yeah, the Sax Club.
Think of all the memorable clashes against Bayley, Charlotte Flair, and Becky Lynch, just to name a few. Was invincible in NXT, every bit as dominant on Raw and SmackDown.
If you look deep into the eyes of Asuka, you can almost see her demise. Already a first ballot Hall of Fame career, but her accolades keep on growing.
Here comes the Queen of Extreme.
And from Sanford, North Carolina, Lita.
You know, so many of today's top women stars say they were inspired by Lita. The likes of Becky Lynch, Bayley,
Liv Morgan.
Yeah, but Lita wants to be more than just an inspiration. Lita wants to remain a top WWE and prove she is still at the top of her game.
The Empress of Tomorrow, Asuka, ready to get this match started.
There are so many things that make Asuka a dangerous opponent. Not only can she knock your lights out with one strike or kick, but she has absolutely no fear.
We can already see that unflinching look on the face of Asuka, and I can only imagine how fierce her offense will get here.
And then you have the original daredevil of the women's division, Lita. Often imitated, never duplicated.
To describe Lita in the most concise terms, she's a badass, plain and simple. A
lot of energy left in that kick out. This matchup isn't anywhere near over.
She had it scouted.
Arm trap, oh my. Sit out, spine buster.
She can end it here.
Not even a one count there.
She is still very much in this. Got their pick set up.
Dusty got in trouble.
Sent crashing to the floor. She heads out of the ring.
Interesting strategy.
Mat slam
with some attitude.
Series of elbows, looking to create separation. She does so.
Four.
Toss back into the ring. Oh, what a windup.
Asuka turns it around.
Gotta find a way to get out of this. She steers clear of that one. Places her right in the corner.
Uh-oh.
Thunderous powerbomb. I felt the vibration of that one from all the way over here.
Inside the ring right now is so potent, you can feel it in the air.
No question, these superstars have nothing but contempt for one another. The entire WWE Universe has been unable to keep their eyes off this feud.
Can you blame them? Every time they clash, it's a highlight-worthy moment.
Look out! Oh, got caught.
That was a powerbomb with one message in mind.
Asuka, we're gonna put this one away. The Asuka lock.
The Asuka lock.
Uh-oh. Think about.
Oh, look at this. Just breaks the grip, delivers an elbow, and just like that, she's back out of it. Chuck to the outside.
I got a strong feeling there's more to come.
Gonna take it high risk. Will it pay off?
Suicide dive!
That is reckless abandon being shown.
And paying off as well. Everyone get out of the way. These two are bending all the strengths.
She set back in under the ropes.
Incredible. The tip-lift German suplex. That is the kind of move that leaves our jaws on the floor. Unbelievable.
Look at this Fireman's Carry takedown. And that was offense with a hurtful purpose.
Uh-oh,
she has trouble coming. Not going to be easy to get out of there.
And she releases the hold as she feels that enough damage has been done.
Should have kept on wrenching. Why show mercy now?
This match is wearing her. That might be it. She powers out immediately there.
Yeah, she probably knew that cover wouldn't do it.
Directly to the gut. Asuka setting up.
This could be it. Cover for the win.
We got a look there.
Lita is reeling to her feet.
It's locked in. She's in a tremendous amount of pain. Is she going to tap out? Can she hold on?
This is absolutely...
And for some reason, she lets go of the hold.
Could have just been a tease of the potential agony that's yet to come.
Lita was ready for that one.
A armbar. Lita's hopes are waning here.
As I said earlier, Asuka can never go wrong with those hard, quick, downright dangerous strikes at her disposal.
Staved up that attack. Picking up speed, building momentum. And that just won't get it done.
Going for the arm bar and a...
Just stretching out the arm.
I don't know how there's anything left in these superstars' bodies.
Yeah, the tank is being emptied tonight.
And just efficiency and precision on display from Asuka.
Yeah, Lita has to wake up and fast.
Lita starting to get the crowd involved.
Separation.
Look at this, going counter for Kent.
Smooth transition.
And just able to make it to the ropes. That was a close call.
Lita is really falling behind.
The Empress of Tomorrow has been relentless in this matchup.
Ah, she fights Lita back.
Asuka managing to find some of that neat.
Lita with a kick to the body.
Will that stop Asuka?
You gotta be kidding me. Everyone here is in shock.
Lita has to ask herself, what more is it going to take here?
Oh, look out.
Big miss right there.
Oh, my gosh.
The Undisputed Champion.
Oh. What do you say? I mean, this is amazing.
She's fighting back.
Each superstar trying to stay a step ahead.
Each competitor showing they've done their homework.
Face first, blackjack.
And Lita once again finding the will to stay in this matchup.
A sudden turn of events forcing the Empress to scramble for an answer.
Kick to the gut by Lita.
DDT. Did Lita clinch this? Is it enough? The cover. Not even a two count. What unbelievable power. This crowd has been building, and they are at a fever pitch right now.
You can feel the anticipation growing with every second that ticks past in this match.
Bang and screw.
That'll tear your knee up.
Taking this one back to the ring now.
Down. Look at Asuka. It's hooked up. The Asuka.
No one gets out of this.
Is there any way out? Can they do anything to break the hold? And they do.
Oh, man, just punishing.
What a hit from Asuka.
Looking to apply an agonizing arm bar stretch.
Just stretching out the arm.
From the middle rope.
Oh, she lands hard.
Oh, look at this.
She had a solid plan, but just couldn't execute.
Ooh, treading all over their opponent. Man, a little extra luster behind that kick.
Kick to the back.
She saw that one coming.
This is gonna be difficult.
And the rope saver there.
Asuka. Uh-oh, Asuka's found her positioning.
It's cinched in. Tap out and call it a night.
Oh, nowhere to go, nowhere to hide. Could be tapped out.
That's it.
That was a massive victory.
It was certainly a treat for all of us to watch here tonight. This superstar can now enjoy victory.
Oh,
what?
Oh no, not the steel chair. Come on!
This is absolutely heinous. Totally uncalled for.
A man, an animal, who has done it all in WWE.
The following contest is an elimination match. Making his way to the ring from Washington, D.C., weighing in at 290 pounds, the Animal.
Punish with no remorse and no mercy.
Batista's story is that of indescribable rage.
He has this insatiable desire to inflict pain on his prey.
Yeah, it is really frightening when you think about what Batista is truly capable of.
He won the Royal Rumble in two different decades. He's a decorated champion, a Hollywood action movie star.
And Batista doesn't care what anyone thinks. He's obsessed with what he wants. And what Batista wants is domination.
Time to unleash the rage.
Well, this is an extraordinary sight. Goosebump-inducing. The awe-inspiring entrance of The Undertaker.
Darkness has completely engulfed this entire building.
Admit it, Byron, you're scared.
A little bit.
We are seeing a legend in the flesh.
And from Death Valley, weighing in at 309 pounds, The Undertaker!
Sinners, beware. Your time has come. Enter the Reaper.
You could say daring to confront the Phenom is like digging your own grave.
The Undertaker will drag you through the depths of despair.
When you see The Undertaker, you're witnessing one of the most amazing spectacles in sports entertainment history.
Without question, Michael, a merciless force of destruction. When The Undertaker is around, no one is safe.
Defined dominance at WrestleMania year after year. One tombstone after the next. Fallen legends, fallen champions.
The quest for everlasting life in WWE goes through the dead man, if you dare.
The dead man's wrath is unending.
An unspeakable reign of terror over the WWE.
And this is the moment where there is no turning back for The Undertaker's opponent.
Welcome to damnation.
Survived Judgement and embraced his darker side to become even more dangerous than ever before.
And from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 249 pounds, Edge!
You know, Edge has won and cashed in the very first Money in the Bank contract, and he's found so many unique ways to win. He is truly the ultimate opportunist.
Six-foot-four, over 550 pounds.
And from the land of the rising sun, weighing in at 558 pounds. Yokozuna!
What makes Yokozuna so scary is his ability to use his massive frame or surprising agility to earn the win in any situation.
Well, that ability, Corey, has earned Yokozuna victories over all-time greats like Bret the Hitman Hart, the immortal Hulk Hogan, and The Undertaker. A very focused look on the face of Yokozuna right now, who no doubt is ready for battle.
I suggest Yoko's opponent take heed of the ominous warning, Banzai.
Kross's return.
A man who changed the entire wrestling world and is now ready to prove himself again in the WWE. Entertainment.
Lord of Darkness has arrived.
I didn't think it'd be possible, but somehow the Undertaker has become more sinister and even more evil.
And from Death Valley, weighing in at 330 pounds, the Undertaker
has been leading the Ministry of Darkness and spreading evil in WWE.
Right, but there are still so many questions about the higher power Undertaker himself claims to be at the service of.
I think the question is now, who can stop the Undertaker or the Ministry? Undertaker's frightening power and his agility, but now he has the forces of evil at his side.
Men of the world, Brock Lesnar.
The Texas Rattlesnake looks ready to hunt.
Now buckle up, we are about to see a fight.
Victoria, Texas, weighing in at 252 pounds, Stone Cold Steve Austin!
Amazing return to the ring at WrestleMania against Kevin Owens.
Oh, how can we forget about multiple occasions where Byron Saxton received a stunner?
Oh, guys, do you have to remind me of that again? That stunner hurt.
It was the greatest moment of my professional career.
I agree. The ring is almost overflowing with superstars in this eight-pack match. So many superstars, but only one will win.
What odds for all competitors involved, but each and every one will fight to the finish. I guarantee it.
Pin drop.
Oh, see that?
Looking for the victory. He got the shoulder up in time. I don't know what more the superstar can do to put him away. And what's the difference between preparing for a false count anywhere match to say a no DQ?
In a no DQ or extreme rules match, you'd at least have to be pinned in the ring. But not here. There truly is no safe harbor, so it's important to mind your surroundings.
Double suplex!
Backdrop suplex.
Doing whatever it takes. And that was an effective attack, guys.
Don't come over here!
Can't use Saxton as a human shield.
Quick thinking pays off. Undertaker gets reversed. Sit right back. Undertaker lands hard ringside. He's outside. He's going for the pin. This could be it. He wasted no time kicking out there.
On the victory parade.
Oh, colliding with a barricade. I don't know what they're looking for here.
The steel chair. Never as innocent as it looks.
And this might not have a cousin Andy. Stop it! This has been a colossal battle at this point. No superstar is showing signs of backing down.
We are seeing all their best on display, but it might just come down to who can take advantage of a pivotal mistake.
Sean Bain thinks so. He thinks he has it. Instantly, he has his shoulders up.
He refuses to stay down.
Pure instinct. Incredible to think. After everything we've witnessed, we are still at a stalemate. The WWE Universe is showing their appreciation for the action they're seeing. It has been an absolute war out there. These superstar efforts are not lost on this crowd. And planted them with a well-executed DDT. He leaves the ring and there's no countouts in this one. Oh, got Austin back.
Finds room and lands a jawbreaker.
Ooh, brutal.
The dead man has him on.
one way to do it.
And a kick out of only one.
What?
Counters.
Reversal after reversal. These two are ready for each other.
And we're still seeing plenty of fight left from Edge.
That should do it right there.
Oh, he breaks up the pin.
Well delivered suplex.
Kick out before three.
Oh, he gets the shoulder up before three.
Edge is displaying an enormous amount of grit right now.
And guys, we're seeing one of those rare opponents that can take everything the Undertaker dishes out. Let's see if the Dead Man can put that final nail in the coffin.
This is a pretty dangerous place to fight. Screens, exposed metal, ledges, so much could go wrong very quickly.
Disbelief over how he managed to.
Yokozuna grabs him. Set it up.
He's going to the pin. This could be it.
He kicks out before the count starts.
You got a question. How much is it worth? How much is it worth to continue through the agony?
It's obviously worth everything. Obviously worth every drop of sweat on the ground.
He steps foot in the ring again.
Taker with an ominous gaze toward his opponent.
gut.
He'll head to the ring. And just like that, he's sent crashing to the floor. Heads out, and he has all the time he wants.
Refuses to stay down.
Pure instinct.
Single leg drop kick caught him. Yeah. Reversal. Can he take advantage?
Seeing an answer for every move attempt.
Round and around. Look at this velocity.
Tombstone pile driver.
The Undertaker.
Has a predisposition for not giving up. This case was no different.
Seeing a little bit of shock on the Undertaker's face. He's ended so many matches this way, but not this one.
Decision there.
Maybe slight hesitation there caused the outcome. Great awareness by the dead man.
Fires back with a knee across the midsection.
There's the arm ringer. Followed by a leg drop.
Ready for Undertaker.
And both athletes showing that they have each other's number.
Inelegant exit, but if it works, it works.
Climbing up top, he's got big plans.
Staggering to his feet, but he won't like what's coming next.
From the top, all the way to the outside.
Will it be? He breaks the pin before a one count.
How this match is still going on defies all reasoning.
Return fire from the Undertaker. Lands the elbow. The dead man facing some danger.
The Undertaker cannot be stopped.
Undertaker landing awkward outside. Setting foot in the ring now.
Face first into the chair.
Saw that coming.
And each of these lethal maneuvers have got to be taking a toll.
And you can tell there are true intentions in mind right now.
The Undertaker with a vintage.
Tombstone. The Undertaker in a bad way.
This is it.
Belief over how he managed to get the shoulder up.
Oh, that can rock you.
Undertaker draining the life out of his opponent.
Taker needs to rise again.
Right across the back of the shoulder. Undertaker's lost all power. The dead man is looking beatable.
Round and around, look at this velocity.
This ends now. Any more hits in that area could be.
Superstars put on quite a show. Here's another look.
Here is your winner, The Undertaker!
And what an uphill battle it was to outlast every other superstar in this match.
Oh yeah, you have to believe this win is going to stick with them for a long time. Surviving against all these other superstars and standing tall here and now.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship!
This man, what the Rock is called.
The Great One is here!
The biggest crossover star!
Arena.
Hey guys, unsurprisingly so, social media right now is buzzing.
Well, because he represents millions and millions, literally. More than 415 million followers on social media. They smell it all right. Indeed, the Great One. Stepping up to the tribal chief and the entire bloodline.
I hope this guy brought a lunch because it's going to be a long, long night.
The bloodline has arrived, and the mood has just changed.
You are looking at a group that straight up runs things around here. Countless titles among these men, countless accolades, and they're only getting started.
And Michael, that is a frightening thought for the rest of the WWE locker room.
A decade ago, Roman Reigns set foot in WWE alongside two men, and they changed the world. I dare say the Bloodline is even more dominant than that group.
When you look at the titles and the main events that Reigns and the Usos have won, it's hard to argue.
This superstar realizes the opportunity in front of them as they prepare to go one-on-one with the Great One.
Introducing the challenger from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, The Rock! And his opponent from Pensacola, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, he is the WWE World Heavyweight Champion,
a title coveted by legends and hungry young talent alike.
Here you have the championship on the line. Champion on high. Ladies and gentlemen, we're in store for something special.
Just disrespectful.
Boom, what a kick.
Rock moves in the nick of time.
Into the chop block, a debilitating counter there. Hoisted way up high. This is gonna be bad. He's got him scouted.
Slow takedown.
Oh, no, wait a minute.
What power. Challenger's a little worse for wear now.
Setting up neck breaker position.
Oh, forearm to the back.
Attacking the knee. Oh, perfect kick.
Oh, my goodness, dribbling the opponent's head like a basketball.
Crafty way to get out of harm there.
Oh, an inverted atomic drop. Very nice.
Ooh, again. Oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off.
He's able to sidestep there. And that was an efficient form of offense with that move. Every time The Rock steps into that ring, it is an event. So what do you think he has to do to make sure?
Reigns delivers a Superman punch, not dead yet.
The champions need to finish the job. Makes a cover. A kick out. Simply refusing to let this opportunity slip away.
And who knows if there'd be another shot, yet you can't give up now.
Roman has been denied. This is not something we're used to seeing, and by the looks of things, neither is Reigns.
This incredible. Ooh, answer that
shown here.
Oh, that's a good throw.
What's he gonna do here? Oh, that hurt.
Reigns gets out of harm's way.
Oh, that was just malicious.
Insulting.
Oof.
Was ready for that. He gets out of the way.
Countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside and gets tossed back into the mat.
Two.
The Rock reminding us all once again that we are watching the most electrifying man in sports entertainment at work.
Had that move from The Rock scouted.
Back. Uh-oh.
Saw that one coming. Took advantage. The champ's shoulders are down. And a kick out right away.
I was not expecting that from him at this point.
Big counter from Reigns. Counter into a jawbreaker.
Pulls their opponent in.
Belly to belly. These superstars have endured so much punishment.
Certainly looking worse for wear, but the tide can shift at any moment. Hoist it up.
Nice suplex. Vertical suplex. Champ taking the worst end of the exchange. What impact! And they just put Roman Reigns about to put his opponent away. No getting up from this.
Boom! The champ has this one in hand.
Let's take another look at these guys in action.
Here is your winner, and still WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Roman Reigns.
We'll be right back.